Welcome students. Previous video class we discussed about alternate entry angles are equal, yes or no, and you proved with the help of which axiom? Yes, corresponding angles axiom. Corresponding angles axiom is very essential for each theorem we are going to do. Okay, now today we will see theorem to show that interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary, right? So the statement, if transversal intersects two lines, two parallel lines, then interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. What is the meaning of angles are supplementary? Yes, speak yourself. Yes. Supplementary angles means sum of the measures of both angles is 180 degree. Okay, that will prove again in very short time. What is given here? If theorem is there, means the statement something is given. What is given? Very good. Parallel lines. Then we get a law. Parallel lines. See. N parallel. Now let us name it. See how the statement given, you have to write yourself what is given, you have to draw what is given. Okay. Now, first set of given, a parallel N. N is transversal. Drawing and writing given carries 1 mark, remember it. To prove, yes. Interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. What are the interior angles? This one, yes or no? And this. Right? Now to show, to prove angle P, you can give numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 180 degree. Angle 3 plus angle 4 equal to 180 degree. Angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 180 degree. Angle 3 plus angle 4 equal to 180 degree. Okay? 180 degree, 180 degree means sum is 180, these angles are supplementary. Now, proof. So, we will try to take support of corresponding axiom, corresponding angles axiom. Now, corresponding angles we will need, so we can take some other angles, no? See, I am naming, suppose I am taking this angle. See, you can take any one, only one angle is required to mark. You can mark this, or this, or this, or this. Only one. Okay? See, I am marking, suppose, where to mark? Okay, let us take this or this. This or this. Anyone. I am marking this, suppose, C4, this is 5. What if? Now, see, look here. 3 and 5 are supplementary. Yes or no? 3 and 5 are supplementary. So, 3 equal to 5 and 5 equal to 2. 5 equal to 2. Yes or no? What if? If I say 3 equal to 5, 5 equal to 2. Or see, 3 equal to 5 and 4 plus 5 equal to 180. 4 plus 5 equal to 180. See, all these relations, linear angles in linear pair, corresponding angles, vertically opposite angles, all these pairs are very useful. Now we want to show 3 plus 4 equal to 180. We have shown 3 equal to 5, see? Angle 3 equal to angle 5, corresponding angles. number one. Okay, again I'm making angle 4 plus angle 5 equal to 180. What are they? Angles in linear. Number 2. Now see, 5 equal to 3. So I can replace this 5 by 3. I can replace this 5 by 3. This implies angle 4 plus angle 3 equal to 1. 3 plus 4, 180. We want to do 3 plus 4, 182. Right? Similarly, we can write angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 182. Hence, how simple? Very simple. You need only corresponding angles in that pair and replace get good. For the same theorem again, converse is there. If sum of interior angles on the same side of transversal is 180 degree, then these lines must be parallel to each other. Okay? So this is to be just remember. These are required in numericals. Okay? Very good. Now see children, all of you. What is converse? If interior angles on the same side of transversal of any two lines are supplementary, then these lines must be parallel to each other. Remember this. Very good. Now, see all of you students, we'll talk about some examples based on transversal and parallel lines. Very interesting and very simple also. See, I am drawing it. Look, I am drawing one diagram. Yes, L, M, N, L parallel M. Okay, now I am drawing these bisectors, angle bisectors. Suppose I am making A, B, C, D, B, Q, X, and this is a Y. Okay. And fine now. So, can you tell me what is this A, X, Y, and X, Y, B? These are alternate interior angles. And let us take it. X, R, and Y, S are bisectors of the alternate interior angles. Then you will show that you will see that bisectors of the alternate interior angles of parallel lines are parallel to each other. Remember, this example right now. So that bisectors of alternate interior angles formed by transversal of two parallel lines are parallel to each other. See, you need words so that bisectors of alternate interior angles formed by transversal of two parallel lines are parallel to each other. Two parallel lines are parallel to each other. See, now from these words we have to write, understand alternate interior angles, transversal, parallel lines, and draw paths. Name properly yourself. You have to name it. Okay, from given example we should be able to understand. understand what is given, and if we understand what is given, we can draw the lines. After drawing lines, we can name ourselves. Right? Now see, look here, what are the bisectors? X, R and Y, S. What to prove? See, what is given? What is given? N parallel N. N transverse. Okay, and what to prove? XR, YSR, bisectors. XR and YS are angle bisectors. Angle bisectors of alternate interior angles. Of alternate interior angles. To prove what to prove? XR parallel YS. To prove XR parallel YS. Okay. Now to prove. Very, very simple, very simple. Okay, now see, we know, students, AXY equal to XYD, alternate interior angle. Yes, or see, angle AXY equal to angle XYD, alternate interior angles. Right? Children, just a minute. Okay, now I am taking half on both sides. Therefore, half angle AXY equal to half angle XYD, half angle AXY equal to half angle XYD. Now see, these are halves. That means I am marking 1, I am marking 2, this is 1, this is 2, half of AXY I can take this angle or this angle. Okay, therefore angle 1 equal to angle 2. These are halves, this is half, this is half. We can take any one half. We want to prove these are parallel. So we need these angles. If these angles are taken, these angles have to come in again, alternate inter angles. Okay, because for this XR and YS, XY becomes transversal. Okay, now see, if angle 1 equal to angle 2, they are forming alternate inter angles, alternate interior angles. And we have written converse. If alternate inter angles are equal, then lines are parallel. Okay, so this implies that XR parallel YS. What will be support? Converse of alternate inter angles. You have to give support. Remember it. By giving support, our conceptual understanding, application capability improves. Remember it, children. Right? And hence prove. Hence prove. See. You got it. What do you need? Drawing correct diagram. Leveling. Okay. You must remember alternate inter angles. Simply take half of the alternate inter angles. If alternate inter angles half of both is taken, we got the new pair of alternate inter angles found equal. And if alternate inter angles found equal, then converse theorem speaks. That is what? The lines must be parallel and hence. Okay. So see, students, see the video at least 2 times with full concentration, write statements and try to solve yourself. Okay. We will see in now 2nd video. Okay. Other examples are very, very again easy and important to find.